Hey friends, welcome back to my channel. I am bringing you my Trader Joe's grocery store haul today. This is my first grocery haul, so I am definitely eager to hear what you guys think about it in the comments below. Do you guys like these types of videos? Definitely let me know and give it a thumbs up if you love it. Trader Joe's is my all-time favorite grocery store to shop at. I love the selection of produce and just so many different things. Every time I go, there is something new to try. And I don't know, my dad is like a total foodie and I just kind of grew up appreciating different flavors and different styles of food. So I remember when I was a little kid, my grandpa was always so proud of me because I would always try something new once. And that is something that we are trying to pass on down to our kiddos. We don't care if they eat an entire plate of something that they don't enjoy, but we just want them to take one bite and test it out. And I remember my grandpa giving me caviar, and I was probably like 6 or 7 years old. And he told me what they were, and I promised I would take a bite, and it was the most disgusting thing I had ever had in my life, and I've sworn I will never try it again. But I at least tried it that one time. So we love Trader Joe's because of all of the new things and fun flavors that they are always coming out with. And so we always like to try new things. That is why we love Trader Joe's so much. And if you don't have one, I'm so sorry. I know one of their sister stores is Aldi, so maybe you guys have an Aldi and can test out some things there. They do also have fun and exciting things as well. I would love to know what your favorite grocery store is, so please share that with me. I also wanted to say that this is a fairly large grocery haul just because I am trying to stock up on things so that I'm not going to the store very frequently. So I'm trying to not go all the time and get exposed to all the germs. So yeah, let's get started. So first up, I have some meats. I didn't go overboard here because we do have some things in the fridge that need to be eaten, as well as some frozen meat in the freezer. But my 5-year-old requested burgers on the grill for dinner tonight. So I picked up some turkey burgers as well as some chili lime chicken burgers. We've had these before and they're really flavorful and delicious. So I'm looking forward to that tonight. We already have buns and all of the fixings, so it was nice to just pick these up. And then I grabbed some chicken breasts. We are going to make one of my favorite salad recipes, and we need some grilled chicken for that. So I grabbed chicken, and then if you've been around at all, you know that we love chicken sausage, especially the ones from Trader Joe's. We love the roasted garlic and the spicy jalapeno, and I also love the sun-dried tomato. So we are going to do like a one-pan dinner with some veggies and this chicken sausage. I also grabbed a spring mix to go with our salads, and then a ton of vegetables because we are like fresh out and I like to have a veggie with every meal if possible. So I just felt like we needed to stock up. So I got some broccoli. I love the convenience of pre-cut veggies that are already washed and ready to go, just because it saves so much time on dinner. We are big fans of broccoli with everything but the bagel seasoning in the oven. And then I thought that I would give these a try. They are organic flat green beans. We have never had these specific ones before, and they just looked like really easy to make as a side dish to go with the dinner. This cauliflower stir fry is one of my favorites. I love to cut up some chicken sausage and just mix it in with this. It makes for a super easy lunch or dinner. It's so good. It's made out of cauliflower, of course, and then it has green peas, red peppers, grilled corn, tamari, I'm probably saying that wrong, spring onions, sesame oil, and ginger. It is so flavorful and it like literally melts in your mouth. It is so good and everyone in our family loves it. I also snatched up this organic foursome vegetable medley. I thought that would be a great little easy veggie side. And my 5-year-old has informed me that carrots are his absolute favorite food, and we were out, so I had to get some carrots for him. He is so funny, like every week he has a new favorite food, but we got some carrots. I also grabbed 2 containers of fennel. When I first had fennel, my mind was blown. It is the most delicious thing in the whole entire world. We were in Wilmington visiting some family and Chad's uncle whipped this up for us. I am obsessed. It is my favorite, favorite, favorite vegetable. I could eat it for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. It's amazing. So I will be also including this in a what's for dinner video coming up soon so I can show you how I prepare it. And yes, my kids even love it too. I'm starting to run out of space at my table. I don't know how far you guys can see over here, but it's basically just a huge pile of everything that I have shown you guys. I grabbed 2 bags of sweet potatoes. We go through like an entire bag for our family, just about probably like 5 or 6, because they're really little and skinny. Sometimes I will pop them in the microwave if we just need like a really quick side, but we love to do sweet potato fries in the oven or on the grill, and we also like to just do diced roasted sweet potatoes. I also grabbed some green beans. They are already cut and washed and ready to go. They're microwave friendly, but I am going to saute these on the stove, probably as a side with our burgers, and I'm gonna add in some bacon and some onions and some garlic, and it's gonna be so yummy. I also grabbed zucchini because we are big fans of zucchini over here, and it also is so tasty with a one pan dinner. And I'm gonna probably mix this together with our broccoli and our chicken sausage. A few weeks ago, I introduced my boys to ants on a log. They were obsessed. So I got some celery so that we can chop it up and put some peanut butter, and we're gonna do cranberries. I think the traditional ants on a log is raisins, but my kids like cranberries more. So we're gonna do that for a snack this afternoon. I grabbed some fruit. We are flying through clementines these days. We probably go through almost a bag a day because the kids wanna eat them for every meal, and I'm okay with that because I am totally fine with them getting all the vitamin C right now. We got some Honeycrisp apples, and then I just got a bag of some Bartlett pears, which we love. I tried to stick to mostly healthy foods for this grocery haul because we are just kind of trying to get rid of all the sugar in our house and get back on a good eating plan. But this is my favorite frozen meal from Trader Joe's, and I just had to grab a bag really quick. It's their chicken chow mein. You can make it in like 6 or 8 minutes on the stove. It is so quick and easy to make, and it really is so delicious. It's full of flavor, and it's just amazing. It is a huge mom win if you are in a rush, and it's fairly affordable as well. We have been out of applesauce for a little while, and my kiddos absolutely love it. So I snatched up 2 jars of their unsweetened applesauce. And then I just grabbed a few canned goods. We got some canned corn to go with some of our other dinners. And then I grabbed some baked beans. We haven't had them in forever, and I saw them on the shelf, and Chad really likes them, so I thought I'd snatch up a couple of cans. You guys know that I love my garlic salt and parsley mix that I have from Aldi, but I'm almost out. Shocker. So I found this one at Trader Joe's. It's garlic salt. So it's sea salt, roasted garlic, onion, and parsley. So it's almost the same, but it also has onion. I thought I'd just grab it and give it a try. I think it was like $1.99. So super affordable, and I think it's gonna be really yummy on some of these veggies. Okay, I'm starting to run out of room, but I have our organic tri-color quinoa. This is my favorite quinoa. We've tried so many different ones, but this is actually for our salad. So it's going to be so delicious. I don't want to give it away because I am going to put it in a what's for dinner, but this quinoa is the best. I couldn't leave Trader Joe's without grabbing a bag of Bombas. We probably have 3 in our snack cabinet, but our family goes through these so fast. We all love them. They only have a couple of ingredients in them, and they just taste so good. I also snatched a box of Raisin Bran cereal for the kids. They really like this one. These are a couple other snacks for the kids. We got some veggie sticks. They love these granola bars. These ones are like a maple and oats granola bar, and then these peanuts and dates, which they all really love. I also grabbed these chia bars for the kids. We love this bread. It is the softest bread you will ever eat, and it lasts for a good while, and the kids really love it for sandwiches for lunch. I haven't been to Target or Aldi in a while, which is where I usually get my sparkling water. I usually drink like 4 or 5 a day. I might have a problem, but they're my favorite, and there's no sugar or fake sugar or sodium or anything in them. It's just carbonated water. And I'm going crazy because I haven't had it for like a week. So I just grabbed their lemon sparkling water and their, what is this one? Cranberry clementine. I thought that sounded good. And I love hash browns for breakfast. Sometimes I'll have them with an egg, or if we have like turkey bacon, I'll make a few pieces. But this is one of my favorite quick and easy breakfasts, so I had to restock. And yes, I did say that we are starting to eat a little healthier, but I saw these, they're new, and like I said, we like to try new things at Trader Joe's. These are almond flour chocolate chip cookies, and what I love about them is they are also vegan. I can't have milk, Mila can't have eggs, so I thought that we would just give these a try and just test them out, right? You gotta try something new. We are getting so close to being done. Thank you guys for sticking around. My chair here is full of groceries, and this whole half of the table is full. I will give you guys a little view at the end, but they did finally have some hand sanitizer back in stock. The last couple of times that I've been out to the grocery store, it's been completely gone. So they had a limit of 2, which is perfect. So I can have one in my car and Chad can have one in his. Their hand sanitizer is so yummy. It kind of smells like tangerine. And we've been using it for the last couple of years, but I feel a lot better being able to have some hand sanitizer in my car. Another thing that I grabbed is one of their sheet face masks. I love this one so much. There's two that I love, and I have very sensitive skin. It's like combination oily skin, and I have to be really, really careful. I have some allergies to some like skin product ingredients. This one is great. I love it. It's really cooling. It's great for just relaxing at the end of the day. I try to use one of these once a week, whether it's from here or the other one I love is the Burt's Bees charcoal hydrating mask, and I get mine at Target. This one's $1.99. I think that one's either $1.99 or maybe $2.99, but super affordable and just like a nice way to treat yourself at the end of a busy week. The last thing that I grabbed is the lavender dryer bags that they have. I love to have these on hand, and I've been out for a while, and I was just looking in the aisle, you know, as you do, and I was like, oh yes, I need those, perfect. So I snatched up another container of these. They're great. How many are in here? There's 4 bags, and they last several cycles in the dryers, and they just make your clothes smell so good when they come out of the dryer. Okay friends, that is all for today's video. If you love this grocery haul, make sure you let me know below and give this video a thumbs up. If you are not already subscribed to our channel, please go ahead and do that. Share this video with a friend if you loved it, and let me know what you're loving from Trader Joe's. We have so much great content coming your way. We are continuing to renovate our master bedroom. We are giving it a farmhouse update. We are creating an accent wall. We are painting the entire room, changing all of the hardware, changing out the light fixtures, and decorating. So make sure you stay tuned for that and hit that notification bell so that you don't miss a thing. I'll see you guys in the next one.